I cannot believe this man. No fear. Yeah, this is a big lab day. I have a feeling after about 36 hours, it is not possible for me to lose to this character again the same way. Why don't we play Ino for a bit? Oh, she's... I can taste how effective this character is now. Ha! It combos on normal hit on standing as well? Oh, shit.
You're nasty.
This character's crazy. Alright, so this one change probably shoots this character into the sky as far as character strength goes. I think she's probably fighting for top 5 now. And this is the only change it took. This is it. This is all that was required. The fact that this character has normal hit JS into JD crouching or standing, probably on every character, it doesn't matter what you do. You cannot fight this. There's no matchup. There's no matchup knowledge that can help with this. You just have to take the mix and you have to fight in other places. They made this character really strong, which is fine, but this is not something you can fight. There's no right answer. There's nothing you can do. You just have to block. Can you jab between the JS and JD? No, it's a true block string. There's like a 2-frame gap. The reason why Leo is such a fucked up character is because his defense and his like mid-range game is so good. Like, Guilty Gear is a game of where characters are strong offensively, right? But Leo is also a mix-up based character where you can just beat everybody. Like, there's so many options to put on the stack that the threat is very significant, right? Ino is the same way, except her mix-up is probably a little bit more potent and her mid-range game is not as good. So, what you need to do when this character is pressuring you, there's basically nothing you can do until you block the mix-up. There's nothing you can do. The mix-up is very obviously invisible. You can guess on wake-up, but now you have to think about, like, what is the percentage chance that you will escape something. So we're going to open the whiteboard. When it's Diaphone versus Hotashi, Hotashi has Diaphone in this position. When Diaphone is in this position, Diaphone can look for three things. Three possible defenses. Number one is block, which will cover... Block covers 50% of potential options here. Blocking stops everything here, right? Because Nago is strike throw, right? Nago doesn't have an unblockable. Nago doesn't have, you know, anything like that, right? He can literally only do mids or grab you or 5D you. So if you're afraid of grab, you can backdash, which also covers 50%.
Where's Hotashi, how technical this character is again? Where is he?
But then, there's another one. Mash. What is it about mashing? How likely is mashing to work here? How likely is it to work here? We can give it a 25% chance. 25%. However, with mashing, there's other permutations of that action. If you mash, you take a turn. So, this is what is called the high roll, right? So, this character can only do two things. There's only two options that you can do, but the thing that Nago can do to open up the opponent is what? If you can only strike and grab, what can you do to open up your opponent? Timing, class. Timing. The only way that Nagoryuki can win is by utilizing these two options and then varying the timing, okay? You understand? You can delay your strike and beat out number 2 and 3 and still cover option number 1. But most of the time, 50% of the time, strike beats mash and backdash depending on the timing and also covers if the opponent blocks, right? But you don't get any damage if the opponent knows what they're doing.
Motherfucker is going to be
you don't get any advantage off of just going for strike.
You know that.
So we have to grab. And the only reason that grab works is because strike covers so many options, okay? So we're going to clear the whiteboard. Now we're going to flip the situation. How many options does Nago have to look for here? Low, mid, or super? Overhead, low, grab? We will assume for this situation that there's not going to be any meter on the table. Okay, no meter on Ino's side. I'm gonna tell you all a secret. Naguruyuki is in Ukemi, right? Ukemi state. How many options does Ino have here that Nago needs to look for? Guess what? Doesn't matter. You know why? Because it's impossible. It is impossible to be right. Every option that Naguruyuki has, number one, it starts at a 50-50, which Naguruyuki has no agency in at all, okay? Because it is a pure 50-50 that nobody can humanely block. Doesn't matter how many options Ino can do here. You can't do anything. So layer one, 50-50 safe jump. Layer two, you rarely see layer two. So when you block layer one, what happens in layer two? There's even more shit that Ino can do. There's even more shit. She can re-jump. She can 2K. She can command grab. She can normal grab PRC. There's so much, right? You really, as a person, like, can't even overcome layer one. It's 50-50. There's no outplaying. And this is why Ino, after her revamp on the last patch, can beat anybody, okay? What they gave her in this patch makes her truly fucked up. And that is JS and JH into JD. This is what made this character get on the map. And this is why it doesn't matter. And it doesn't matter what you do on Wake Up, because it is no longer possible to be right. So, what do we do? No. The answer is not... the answer is not high roll. If you high roll, has probably a 15% chance of working. I think that's a pretty safe bet. Kari Safari says, keep the decisions neutral focused. That's what I like to fucking see. This doesn't matter. All of this bullshit doesn't matter. So we go to neutral. And now we're gonna have to focus on raising our win percentage into one place where we have actual control. If you wanna beat certain characters, Chip, Milia, Leo, don't fucking worry about defense, all right? Because that shit is absurdly hard. You have the most room to gain win percentage by learning how to fight these characters in neutral. Let's think about what Ino does mid-range, right? Especially after she does a 2D, which is her typical block string ender. So let's look at 2D. On block, minus 7. So we need to look at the situation where Ino tries to be cheap and gets away with doing 2D nothing. How do we punish that? With 2K. But what does that lose to? S-stroke. Did we just learn something? Versus S-stroke, there's a 3-frame window in which you can grab. There's a possibility there for a fuzzy timing. We know that S-stroke is punished on block in most situations. Smart Enos are going to space this out so they don't eat shit, because it's minus 7, right? What does Ino look for by doing S-stroke? She's looking for you to try and grab H-stroke. Or try and grab the earliest possible S-stroke. So she's going to slight delay, right? Take one of these and put it on slight delay. Even though this is a 7-frame punish, right? Like that. Ino can goad Nago into going for the punish at the earliest possible convenience. So you see, what I'm trying to say is that when Nago blocks this 2D, there's a lot of extra context that happens. The context is in the range at which Nago blocked it. Even though this is minus 7, and 2K will be a great coverall to many options besides immediate S-stroke, we have to think about the range at which this happens, okay? Because this changes everything. Because this means 2D is no longer punishable. So what we're doing right now is we're building a decision-making matrix. This situation here, where Nago is this close. In this situation, where Nago is this far away, these are two completely different situations. Okay? And Ino is going to feel very pressed to do something when Nago blocks the low this close. Because she gets punished on block for doing 2D nothing. This is the worst case scenario.
Motherfucker is going to be telling everybody he's moist. You're nasty. You know that.
This is not a 50-50 situation at all. Unlike being knocked down by Ino, where you literally are forced to guess. There's actual data that you can use here to change your fate. And make it so that you don't have to guess. Blocking 2K 2D up close. If I were Ino, I would probably be terrified here. Okay? Now I know that Ino is scared out of her mind. Because if Nago lands at 2K, that's what happens. So she's much more likely to do something extra greedy to get out of this. Only things that she can do to protect herself in this situation are all unsafe. So what Ino can do is wait, S stroke, or delay, S stroke. And what I feel is gonna happen a lot of the time is Ino's are going to flip between these two a lot of the time. 50-50. So number one is directly punished by the first level, which is 2K. If Ino waits, she's basically hoping that Nago is afraid of number two, immediate S stroke. This is in a situation where you know that your opponent knows that you know they know. Alright? There's nothing that Ino can do here that is not possible to counterplay. Nago can also 50-50. Immediate 2K. Delay 2K. Both of these instantly make it so that you have mindless. Wait for it. Mindless counterplay. Okay? What do you think mindless counterplay means, chat? Coach Arba says you can brain off 50-50 and it stops a bunch of shit. The moment that Nago blocks this 2D, he has a 50-50 where he can hard punish Ino. Hard punish. Okay? Remember how when Ino knocks you down, it doesn't matter because it's an immediate 50-50? It doesn't matter what Ino does in this situation because she is exposed to a 50-50 on defense now. Okay? And there is nothing she can do. She has to select one way to hang herself to protect her from this situation. But there's going to be a little bit of context added. It depends on how much life Ino has. This is still a 2K punish if Ino waits after 2D, right? But Nago, at this range here, do you see this? You see this? Nago cannot do a combo. When Nago is at this high of a blood, you can't get a combo. What about 2K, 6K? Whoa, look at that. Did you see that? 2K, 6H is a true combo in level 3, level 2 blood. Now this changes the threat assessment for Ino. And this is the type of thing where if you know it and the opponent doesn't know it, they're in deep shit. So that means no matter what the blood is, Nago can get a money punish on blocking 2D. So every time that Ino makes me block a 2D, this is what can happen to her. This is what can happen. And I think this is the hard part of the labbing out of the way. Because what else do you lab? We know that if she rejumps, that's a pretty easy fuzzy mesh, I think.
You're nasty.
2K6H, I think, is true block string. It's true block string. Very simple. That block timing, this block timing, into close slash covers, like, it probably covers everything. See? It's generally pretty scary for Ino to, like, try and grab Nago. So, like, jumping is, like, not on the table for me. The fact that it's possible is the most important thing.